atmosphere in Belfast. Big roar from the crowd as the first bell goes, and the first round's going to be interesting. He did everything wrong against Rossi Warren Jackiana back in February. He stood off a talented, technically good boxer, and he got pinned with shots and found himself down twice. He cannot afford that kind of start again, and early signs are here, Andy, as he's looking to shut Burnett down and get right on top of him.
So what was expected from Jackiana? He really is a bull and is always trying to come forward. Interestingly enough, he's kind of taking a stance where he's leaning to his right and throwing the jab high. He's looking to jab his way in. Ryan still hasn't made it out of his corner yet. That's just mainly down to Zakianov's pressure.
Zakianov just trying to trap the arm of the net down the blind side of the referee, but again, just goes straight back into close quarters. We saw a lot of head clashes here when Burnett fought against Haskins, and that wouldn't be out of the question here tonight. Again, by the look of things, he needed plastic surgery on 3 cuts, Ryan Burnett, but that's all behind him now.
Good whip, another cut from Burnett as his back hit the ropes. I know that's a punch he's been working on in training. I think they were going to see a lot of this early on. Even fight one to give an inch, and Ryan really holding him. You might see a little bit of grappling, and just seeing who's just feeling each other's strength and seeing who's the stronger man there. Good snappy jab from Burnett, but also Zanek. Zakianov came back with his own jab.
He takes himself away from Kazakhstan for camps, for 12-week camps. Zakianov, he's got a twin brother who boxed on the national squad with Gennady Golovkin, who is in the ring holding up that belt behind him, just falling short with that right hand there, Zakianov. Subconscious mind in there amidst all of this bedlam.
Howard Foss is just having a word with him there, trying to find him tidy a little bit. But this is the fight Zakianov wants, kind of ugly, brawling fight. But not getting his punches off, should look like that's it. Punch a move and use that distance. Try to keep Zakianov at the end of his punches. Got to be careful when he's looking for that uppercut, because Zakianov can come with the left hook.
And he's looking for that looking uppercut, wasn't he? And he didn't miss by too much, but that just disengaging and then finding a little bit of space. Just wrestling towards the neutral corner on the far side, but again, Burnett there just shaking himself free and popping off a combination. Interesting first round.
He did land a good jab and a good right hand, but Burnett should be seeing it, had a good look at him in that round, and Ruth would have had a good look at him in that round, and that would probably look, but Zakianov caught him, catching on in the punches, a good left hook from Zakianov there.
Just if Burnett was looking chin, to open up yeah, too.
He's got to be careful throwing that right uppercut because he's leaving his chin exposed.
He sunk it in nicely. Just before that, as he was back in the blue corner, his own corner, Burnett dipped away to right-hand side and landed a nice uppercut, but then as he looked to load up on it a bit more, maybe left himself a touch open, and Zakianov came back with a right and left hand himself.
Burnett's never been one to get on his toes and move and box and try to be like a slick counterpuncher, but he might have to tonight, because he needs to find a way to make, he's got to make Zakianov respect his power. He's going to have to land something telling in the next round or two to make Zakianov think twice about just walking into range like that.
Nice little left on the inside there for Burnett. Zakianov again just comes forward and
walked into the uppercut there, good land.
One thing I saw them working on in the gym when I went down, so sorry, 2 or 3 weeks ago, Burnett and Alan Booth, was turning Zakianov, getting in close, throwing punches, getting in close, and then turning.
Body shot from Burnett there.
It was a good solid one, wasn't it? We could hear that right above us.
They're not getting drawn into the machoism, which I would advise against. Doesn't need to man up. Doesn't need to be Zach Yanov in a competition of being the biggest man in the ring or the biggest having bravado or machoism. He just needs to box and keep him at the end of his punches and use his skill and talent. Heavy shots here from Zach Yanov on the ropes.
Springing forward that left hand, Zach Yanov. He's got a kind of wild stare about him as he focuses on his opponent. And that ring just above us, Burnett just trying to keep that head on the move. Avoid that kind of fast twitch movement that we saw so much of against Haskins. And he's developed since he's been training with Adam Booth. Nice left to the body there from Burnett. Zach Yanov is right back on his shoulder again, cupping right hand, but the Kazakh took it. And inside there, Burnett, Zach Yanov finds just enough room to get that left hand free and land a short punch of his own, and then another one as Burnett's just back. Good for his peace of mind and just for his relaxation to have her there. It's quite unusual, actually. Usually if a fighter takes himself away for count, then he cuts off all ties with everybody, really.
Yeah, she's a good influence on Ryan. She does a lot of the cooking, and it just makes it easier for him while he's in camp. She's always encouraging him, but I've given the last two rounds to Zach Yanov, but I'm conflicted here. Ryan's my friend, and the rounds are very hard to split. I could give it either way. I've just given it to Zach Yanov because he's pressing forward, and he started the last round very well. And Ryan's growing as the fight progresses. Ryan seems to be growing and getting a foothold in the fight, but the first two rounds I got have Zach Yanov.
Looking for the overhand right there, Zach Yanov. A little uppercut on the inside too, and he's just slightly beating Burnett to the punch when they're up close like that. Nice left hand aim there by Burnett, but Zach Yanov dropped the right elbow on it.
This fight is suiting Zach Yanov at the moment. I'm sure he's really happy about the way things are unfolding here. I don't think he would have anticipated this type of fight. Ryan for some reason, only known to him and Adam, and he's choosing to hold his feet. When he's at distance like this, he should be trying to get his punches off and making Zach Yanov pay for coming into distance.
It was a nice combination from Burnett there as he was just backed up to the ropes, and Zach Yanov did give a little bit of ground. He took it some power in the uppercut there. Burnett, I think Zach Yanov managed to lock it for the most part, but comes back with his own right hand, and just a little bit of daylight has appeared between the two now. We haven't seen too much of that in the fight up until this point, and immediately Zach Yanov looks to try and shut it down.
Stab to the body from Zach Yanov with the jab. All of this holding and wrestling and clinching, it drains your energy. You have to be conditioned for that. I know Ryan's trained a little bit for this. Pushing Zach Yanov back now, Ryan. Trying to get his respect. Right hand counter from Ryan.
Zach Yanov just missing with the right hand as he came in there, and his weight just took him forward slightly. We'll need to be wary of that.
Good body shot from Burnett there. Right hand under the elbow.
Foster just warning Burnett about getting careless with the head on the inside there. Their heads are very close together at times. They're rubbing together more than anything else. They haven't really clashed yet as Burnett backs up towards the blue corner. Just saw the water spraying off the head there of Zach Yanov, and another good jab just slung up from the waist, and that got a good reception from that Burnett corner over on the far side.
Zach Yanov, you can see, kind of plants his feet and kind of gets into an almost half a squat position. And from there, it's very hard to move forward or back. Ryan shouldn't be trying to move him back, just trying to hit at him and move around him.
Just dipping the head back, Burnett, and there's a little bit more of that rapid head movement. And then just flicking out that right hand lead. We saw the right hand lead a lot against Lee Haskins, and I think you're right. I think Burnett is just growing a little bit in confidence here in this fourth round.
I think so. I think he's felt a little bit of what Zaki and have had to offer. And now he's starting to employ his own tactics. Good left hook on the inside by Bernard.
Short right hand from Zaki Arnov. Just checked the chin of Bernard and looks to thump in another left.
Two to the body from Bernard there. What people don't understand about Ryan Bernard is that he can do this as well. He can fight inside. And he's very powerful there too. I'm not sure if Zanet Zakianov could have predicted this or expect this from Bernat. It may not be the prettiest to watch, but so far this round has been effective. And he's bullying the bully.
Ryan Foster just telling Bernat not to hold there. Right hand comes in again, and Zakianov just looking to hold on a little bit.
Meaty body shot there from Bernat.
Leaning on here, he's just able to find a little bit of room, Bernat, that he wasn't in the first few rounds, left to the body, but then Jackiano answered that left from Bernat with a good one of his own. This is really sapping stuff. This is going to take it out of you very quickly.
It's kind of a testament to Ryan's conditioning at the moment that he's able to punch with such force after three rounds of grappling.
Jackiano looking to let go of the uppercut, and then immediately as it finished and he missed it, it turned it into a right hand. A couple of good shots off the back foot there from the Kazakh.
Heads coming close together on the inside there.
Stepping him in that front foot there, Jackiano just looking to try and crowd to let his hands go on the inside, because we saw a little bit of a shift in that fourth round, because it was Bernat who was able to do that.
I think they're surprised that Bernat was able to push him backwards. You can see he's come out now. Zakianov with a whole new demeanour. You can see when he gets in position, he kind of goes into a little half squat. He's very hard to move from that. No, he's kind of planted to the ground. Great punches off the ropes from Bernat and calls him back in.
Well, the Irishman's warming to his task here, certainly, but Jackianov, who's not found someone who is going to back off, who's not found someone who's going to be intimidated, or is going to have his will broken, he's proven that to us.
It's a good stiff jab from Ryan, and a good left hook counter on the ropes. He needs more of that jab, just to disrupt the rhythm of Zakianov. That's it.
An abrasion more than anything else, and again they just get to work on the inside.
I think Ryan's trying to prove a point here. He's put on display of conditioning, strength, but he's also trying to prove a point that he won't be bullied one day. There was talk about spars with Zakianov in the past and how he went and broke Zakianov one day. He used the word broke in a spar. And I think he's trying to do that again. I think if he saw some weakness in Zakianov, maybe he's trying to exploit that again.
The left hand from Zakianov is... Bernat again was just dipping low, looking to try and come in and shift through a couple of gears on the inside. Right there from Bernat.
Good combinations from both men. And even fighter can allow any lapse, even a moment in concentration here, because they're both firing back immediately. As soon as right.
Into the sixth, and Jackianov again in those light blue shorts, the WBA super champion in the bantamweight division, looks to come forward again. Nice uppercut on the inside there from Jackianov.
A lapse of concentration there from Bernat, and he paid for it by taking that uppercut. What's happening?
Well, his shoulder He's just reached for his collarbone or his shoulder. I don't think it's serious. It could even have been a head colliding just with the underside of the jaw, possibly, but that's what it looked like. And it's that kind of a fight where the limbs are intertwined on the inside a lot, and they're both trying to extract themselves and really get some leverage in that. An arm injury, a shoulder injury, an elbow, it's very possible.
The amount of grappling, you could easily see how someone's shoulder could become dislocated. And the way their heads are coming close together, you could see more cuts happening as the fight goes on. This is a brutal fight, and it's a testament to both men's conditioning that they're able to stand here and fight like this.
Oh, we saw Lee Haskins suffer a shoulder injury when he lost that IBF title to Burnett, and he just grit his teeth and got on with it, never used it as any kind of excuse at all, which was very much to his credit. Burnett just doubling up with a left hand to the body and then using those feet.
Zach Yanov needs to try maybe just something a little bit different. He's, you can see that his plan is just to walk forward, try to pin Ryan, wear him down. Maybe they're hoping for to come on later on in the fight and hopefully tire Ryan out. That down the stretch, Ryan will tire. If they invest early with this early pressure, they're coming down the stretch. So very close there, both men exchanging right hands and very close to landing.
I think a forearm landed there from Jack Yanov. It wasn't intentional. Just before that, Howard Foster having a stern word with Burnett about heads. He's not really sticking the head in, it's just when they're all...
This round a lot more even. Ryan needs to get on the outside and do a little bit of work if he can, just to really, just to steal the round, really.
Nice 1-2 there from Jack Yanov. He's just got that stoical expression. His facial expression just never, ever, ever changes.
I never seen him show any emotion over the last 2 weeks, and I've been following him, knowing that the fight was coming up. Body shot on the inside from Burnett. Another one. The third one. A little bit low.
Jack Yanov just glancing down towards his belt line and looking icily at Burnett. Referee Howard Foster didn't say anything, didn't make any kind of indication as the bell goes and we reach the halfway point of... Well, at the midway stage, let's have a look at your scorecard, Andy, and see how you've got this. And you've got it dead level, dead level. There's not been much to pick in a lot of these rounds.
It's just whoever's dominating the fight more physically than the punches that landed. And this is extremely difficult for me to score against my friend and teammate. I'm sure when he watches the fight, I hope he doesn't fall out with me. But I just have to call it like I see it and try to be as unbiased as possible. Good left hook inside from Burnett there. He needs to keep his focus and don't get dragged into being preoccupied too much with being the dominant, having been the strong, dominant man in the ring. Be focused on his boxing and on landing effective punches.
Bit of water on the canvas in the red corner, I think, now, because Burnett's back foot just seems to give way beneath him. Zappiano's just got Burnett back in that neutral corner. Good hook. Really find too much of a way through. Nice right hand there, though.
Yeah, good right hand hook from Zach Yanov there. Good response from Burnett. Three punch combination, two to the body and one to the head.
The crowd enjoyed that one.
The heads again coming very close together from both men.
But I'm sure this Belfast crowd, if they didn't already, now feeling a healthy dose of respect for Janet Jack Yanov, because he is a warrior. He is going absolutely nowhere.
I would like to see Ryan maybe try and set something, maybe try and set that uppercut up by throwing. Throwing the jab, right hook, jab, right hook, and then on the third one changing it into an uppercut might have an effect.
He just dipped his head right forward there, didn't it? He was kind of square into Jack Yanov, but it was a peculiar kind of move really, and just pulled it back. Jack Yanov just trying to get something done on the inside as Burnett just leans on.
There's not been any daylight between them at all at any stage.
But he's not been that effective this round, Zaki Anov. Even though he's been at close range, he hasn't manslammed anything telling. And while they're wide at distance and while they're inside, Ryan is landing the telling punches.
It's a nice jab there from Burnett, which landed nice and square on Zaki Anov.
I would like to see Ryan get on his toes now a little bit and just be the matador to the ball. Let Zaki Anov fall short, thank him, let him fall short and just turn him and move him around. And almost in a way, without being proved, make him look silly, you know, box him and move. Make it easy for himself, just for a couple of rounds. He's already proven that he can stand toe to toe. Good punches from Burnett there. The eye-catching punches come from Burnett in this round.
In this round, he's just managed to take half a step. Go to title is vacant, surely, but they both got one, so there'll be none of that discussion here.
You know, it's rare in boxing that you have arguably the two best fighters in the division fighting off. But these two guys, they should be commended for this. You know, anyone would forgive them for taking an easy defense in their first defense. But when the fight was offered to Burnett and Zaki Anov, they both jumped at the chance to become unified champion. And this is why you can see over here in this fight how much it means to them and how hard they're fighting to win that other belt.
Dave Caldwell might have something to say about that, I think. I'm sure he rates Jamie McDonnell up there in the top two in the division also. But that's what makes it such a good division. It's a very competitive division.
I did say arguably.
Well, there'll be plenty of arguments about it, and hopefully they will all be resolved by them all fighting each other. That's all we want to see.
Good,
and that's what we're seeing tonight.
Hooking punches round the side of the head, and one landed, one short left hook landed on the chin. Good first minute for the round for him. Uppercut from Burnett on the inside.
Uppercut was landed well. And again, a similar kind of punch followed by the left to the body, but Zaki Anov just doesn't flinch, he doesn't yield, wilt, or give an inch.
This is a hard, hard fought fight. Both men will be very sore in the morning.
Nice right hand on the inside there from Zaki Anov, just as he had the arms of Burnett pinned in the position where there wasn't really anything he could do with them, and capitalised on it.
It's good work from Burnett when he gets a bit of distance. But it's very hard against Zaki Anov. He's always in forward motion, always looking to come forward, always looking to close the distance.
Well, you talk about things being up close and personal. This is as up close and personal as a fight gets, because they've been right on top of each other right from the very first bell. As soon as it sounded, Zaki Anov was across the ring and looking to try and get on Burnett's shoulder, and Burnett was never particularly discouraged that.
Good clean punches from Ryan there up close. And a good punch to almost land on the hip. I know there's a saw and they really... Burnett has Zaki Anov backed up now. Working at close range, good uppercuts on the inside.
Zaki Anov did a good job there, though, of turning his man, just got a hold of that right arm and then used his feet well, just pivoting around that front foot.
Body shot from Burnett, really put it in.
Well, surely the pace of this has got to tell on one of these two, if not both of them, at some point. It would be incredibly impressive were it not to, because this is very, very hard.
One thing about Ryan Burnett is that he can do this for 12 rounds. He could possibly do 15 rounds. He's the hardest working boxer I've ever trained with in my life. And I've trained with all of it. But
I want you to go out and prove it.
Quite confrontational there from Adam in the corner. Almost laying down the challenge to Burnett, saying, you said you could do it, now show me you can do it. And even though, you know, people would think, and I thought, that Burnett should box a move and make this an easy fight. In the corner, Adam Booth, Roger Lee, they're all being very encouraging of Burnett when he's standing toe-to-toe and trading with Zaki Anov. Hands down now, showing a little bit of flash from Burnett. A little bit of what we thought we might see from him.
And this is obviously what they trained for. This was the plan. drive, looking for a left hand to kind of lead left uppercut, really, but couldn't land it. Just backed off there and found a touch of space to deliver the hook.
That was a good left hook. Ryan Lohman too much. Good double jab left, right hand by Burnett. Great jab, break up jab, stop Zakianov all, stop Zakianov in his face, and a good uppercut, right left hook from Burnett. Really trying to, he's really starting to find a little flow in there now, and maybe it's the pace of the fight, maybe Zakianov is starting to slow down a little bit. But Burnett seems to have found some sort of flow in there and seems to be quite comfortable with the way the fight's going.
Well, just as he walked onto that jab, you could see Zakianov just try and gather himself a bit, just got those feet moving, and Burnett just unloading on him there.
Overcut left by hand and followed with a breakup jab. And a 1-2, great punching from Ronnie Burnett, great boxing.
The crowd really looking to Burnett now to put his foot down inside the final minutes of round 9. Level here has just gone up a few decibels. Zakianov comes back with a sneaky right on the inside, but Burnett just dips his shoulder to his right and shovels that uppercut up the centre again.
This is what this crowd's been waiting for, to see Ryan Burnett in full flow. Oh, heavy left hook from Ryan Burnett off the ropes. Zakianov is one tough man and has a great chin to take that punch.
Zakianov just breaking and throwing the right hand. Burnett comes back with the right as well. Though as the bell goes at the end of it.
Jamie McDonnell, are you on a scouting mission here as well?
No, we've got Solis. Right, we've got here. Solis next. That's all I'm bothered about.
Good, Dave. Well dodged.
Into the 10th. Dave makes a good point there, because I think the more eye-catching work has probably come from Burnett.
And that's why I'm giving him the rounds. I have Burnett ahead now by quite a few rounds, but up to like halfway point, it was almost even. Burnett's doing the more work, just up close and at range. I think Ryan Burnett's doing the more following work. Better be careful with the heads there coming close together. He's starting to employ the jab now, which will have a good effect. Body shot from Ryan Burnett. He's had to take that toll at some stage. I like the little head movements Ryan Burnett is doing inside, up close. It's just little dips and little rolls. It just seems like that. Just makes him that little bit evasive and just makes him slip under the punches.
Just a little bit of marking up under the left eye for Burnett. Inevitable, really, in a fight like this, you would say. But Zakianov just hasn't really got the mark on him at all.
he's ticked tough, I think. And some of the body shots that Burnett has been whipping in would knock down a tree. But he keeps coming forward, Zammer.
He landed a right hand there as Burnett was coming forward too. Just came onto it slightly. And for the first time maybe in the entire fight, when these two just fall into each other, they're a touch slower, a microsecond slower to disentangle themselves. Just looking for a second maybe where they can just get a bit more air in.
Well, it's at that point of the fight now, the 10th round, they know 11 and 12 coming up, and they're the big rounds. So mentally, you kind of just take a little lapse and get ready for the big finish. Seriously good right hand from Ryan Burnett there in the exchange. Landed clean. But again, Zakianov walks forward. They finished the round for Burnett there.
He's in the corner with his fighter's hat, and he seems to really know how to communicate with them, even when there's a language barrier, which there is.
He almost got a smile out of Zakianov. just really trying to motivate his man, saying come forward with four straight and then look for the hooks.
two southpaw briefly there, but that started the round. I haven't seen too much of that.
Yeah, the first time in this fight that he's tried it. Back to Orthodox now.
Looking right hand there from him.
Good jab from the net off the ropes.
Chikianov's got Bennett back in that neutral corner, but he couldn't really do an awful lot with him. He took a little bit of a step back to try and get his hands free, his arms free, but then Bennett just...
I think he's looking to box now a bit for now. I think he said, OK, we fought, now your fight, now try and fight my fight.
Foster just breaking the moon. Good lamp out on the inside there. You could just see the jaw just being flipped from side to side with Chikianov. But again, he didn't even grimace. There was nothing, no reaction to it whatsoever.
This is a display of conditioning. I mean, a skill, strength, speed, all those things, reflexes, but also conditioning. To be able to do this in round 11 after fighting Zaki on his fight, it's quite something to behold.
Are you surprised by the game plan?
A little bit I am. You know, I'm very close with Adam, and, but he's very coy when it comes to talking about game plans, and as much as you'd like to say you wouldn't tell anybody, you know, word gets around. But maybe this was the game plan, maybe this wasn't the game plan, but this is where they find themselves. And Bennett's handing away. Good shots from Zakianov in the inside. Good right uppercut. Gets the acknowledgement from Ryan Bennett there, a shake of the head.
Well, we know how tight some of these rounds have been, and we know that Zakianov is...
on his feet. Andy Lee's scorecard as we head into the final 3 minutes. Let's see how you've got it. You've got Bennett ahead, because from the second half of the fight onwards, you've seen him winning those rounds, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11.
I don't know, I could be biased because my fondness for Ryan, but it's just how I'm seeing the fight. And it's totally subjective, because Zanet is coming forward, he's applying the pressure. And it depends if you value that in your scoring, but I value clean, effective punching, and that's what I've seen from Ryan. The more cleaner punches, the more effective punches have come from Ryan.
Again, they've still got the strength on the inside there to just lean on, just to grapple, bring every ounce that they've got to bear on each other and try and find a little bit of room, just a millimetre, fractions, so they can get those punches away. Still, Zakianov comes forward, looking for those shots. Bennett just digging in his toes and looking for the right hand and then the left of the body.
One, two off the ropes from Bennett, and just dip it ahead and have a little look at Zakianov. Doesn't need to load up now. I can see he's trying to load up, maybe go for a grandstand finish.
And the crowd, the Belfast crowd, is trying to urge him on to exactly that now. First ever unification bout in Ireland. He would be the first ever Irish fighter to achieve this on home soil. And everybody here and everybody watching has been treated to a terrific display from both of these two. It's been hard, it's been gritty, it's been tough all the way through. Look at that there, Bennett just hammering away to the body, with Zakianov just grits his teeth and comes back again.
This has been world-class, I want to say battle, but fighting. These guys have fought tooth and nail. Neither want to give an inch.
Well, we've had plenty of that tonight, haven't we? And you're right, that's what this is. This is a fight. And it's been a fight right from the very, very start. Not necessarily the noble art all the way through, not necessarily the sweet science all the way through, but there's a lot of skill on show in there. But by the bucket load, there's resilience, there's will to win, There's just refusal to take a backward step by either of these two at any point. Well, I'm sure both corners will celebrate this when the bell goes. And they'll be in for a wait for the scorecards. And still they just pour it on. The bell about to go any time now. And there it goes.
Touching to all in favour of the winner. He is now the WBA Super and the IBF Bantamweight Champion of the World. From Belfast, Northern Ireland.
And the tears were coming and the family celebrating. They fall into each other's arms there, Adam Booth and Ryan Burnett. Those two have such a special bond. He's been through a lot, this kid, he really has. His brain scan came back when he was young, when he'd only just started, and he was told that he would never be able to box again. He was standing in what he described as a grotty apartment in Manchester by himself, hearing these words on the end of a telephone line, and his world just fell apart. But he wouldn't accept it. He proved his fitness to box. He and his father went through trials and tribulations as well. They were living in their car in the supermarket car park at one point as they tried to reignite his career. But they did it.